reading only the translation without the word to word, no problem. If they are practicing it in their life, that's more important. If they are chanting sincerely and serving the Vaishnavas and not criticizing anyone, oh, that is more important. But if I am reading through the word to word and I have all the word jugglery and all the commentaries and all the, you know, quote unquote, colorful feathers, but if I am criticizing Vaishnavas or not spending enough time chanting japa, na utpadayet yadi ratim shrama eva hi kevalam. Bhagavatam describes that if my hearing and reading doesn't bring in affection and attachment to the lotus feet of Krishna, oh, then I'm going wrong somewhere. Only one rule in life. Only one rule to attain love for the lotus feet of Radha and Krishna. Nothing else. Absolutely nothing else. We are on high emergency. The world is under fire. Samsara davanala. World is under, let's say for example, I am in Japan. Let's say I'm in Japan and my neighbor's house catches fire. Am I going to learn Japanese to tell that person in Japanese that your house is on fire? I will just call out, right? I will just do something, some sound. I'm not able to communicate, but I will just say it out somehow to that neighbor that your house is on fire. That is how the calling should be, to call out to Krishna. That my Lord, I am burning in the fire of this world. Please help me. Please help me, my Lord. My human life is being wasted. I don't know if I will get another human birth. I don't know. Next life, I may become a pig. Rishabdev Maharaj, then incarnation of the Lord, his son, Bharat, became a deer. Can you imagine? The son of God. Rishabdev Maharaj is an incarnation of Krishna. His first son, Bharat, the first son of the Supreme Lord, becomes an animal. What a disgrace. Can you think about it? But he took it in all humility. He took it in all humility. And he was the king of the whole world. The whole place was called Bharat Varsha after Bharat Maharaj. But Bharat Maharaj, in his all humility, he's teaching the world that you could be the king of the whole creation and you could be the son of God. But if you're attached to anything in this world, like a small deer or a baby deer, then that is where our consciousness is and that's where our next birth is. So to teach us that we are going through disgrace. Why? Because we are all like Bharat Maharaj. The soul is like the first son coming from the super soul, from the Lord, who is God. So the Lord is Rishabdev Maharaj, God. And we as the soul are part and parcel of him, like the first son, Bharat Maharaj. So Bharat Maharaj, through his life, how lovingly, how compassionately is teaching us what disgrace is the soul going through. Being the son of the Supreme Lord, we are taking different births in different bodies. Think about Raja Indradyumna, King Indradyumna becoming Gajendra, the Gandharva Huhu becoming the crocodile. So many cases, countless cases of big monuments, big structures on the path of spiritual life, big heroes coming down as animals to teach us this lesson, that this is what we're all going through lifetime after lifetime. So next life, if we become a pigeon or we become an earthworm, we will not even know. Whole life, we will go through those bodies with no gain. Nrideha madhyam sulabham sudurlabham plavam sukalpam guru karanadharam mayanukule nanabhaswateritam puman bhavabdhim nataretsa atmaha. 11th canto Bhagavatam describes, therefore, O living being, this human form is the most favorable boat. We as the soul are sitting on the boat of this human form. And the words of the Shastras are the favorable winds which help this boat go through. The captain on this boat is the spiritual master. And the ocean is repeated birth and death. The soul, as the passenger, is sitting on the boat of this human form with the captain called as the spiritual master on the ocean of repeated birth and death, where the favorable winds which are pushing us towards our goal are the words of Shastra. But still, If the passenger thinks, I wish I can jump into the ocean and swim in this world, giving up this boat, then Bhagavatam describes such a passenger as a fool. Because he has to just be there in that human form and go through in that right direction. So that way, we will reach the shore, which is back home, back to Godhead. So this human form is to be utilized moment to moment by chanting the holy name, by having proper sadachar, by serving the Vaishnavas and reading Srimad Bhagavatam. Coming back to what Radharani is saying, Gopya, oh gopis, I am Venu, this flute, Kim Kushalam.